One mother shared with me how she used the tool in the barbershop. She used Stay Listening with her son in the barbershop. He usually goes to get his hair cut, and when he goes, it's this big traumatic experience. He's crying, he doesn't want to go, but she usually spanks him and makes him get in the chair and get his hair cut because he needs his hair cut. So this time, after she took the BU class that was offered in our community, she took him to get his hair cut. And mind you, this is a man's territory, so you don't want your son acting like what they call a wimp in the barbershop. So she went with her aunt, and they took the boy to get his hair cut, and then he sat there in the chair like he usually does, started to cry. He doesn't like the razor touching his head. He likes a guard on it, but the barber didn't use the guard. He used the razor. So the little boy's just hysterically crying. He's getting cut on his head from moving so much. And his mom just said, stop. She told all the adults to stop. The barber said, I'm going to pay you to take this boy out my chair. And so she's like, no, I'm going to take my son. She held her son and allowed her son to cry for about 10 minutes. She said he was sweating, throwing up. And she just stayed there with him. And she said, I seen he was scared. He was scared. All these adults were yelling at him, telling him to man up, be quiet. And she's like, she usually joins in and says, I'm going to whoop you. But when she learned the tools, she learned to listen from his point of view, that it was scary for all these adults to be yelling at him. And because she got listening time for herself, she was available to do that for him. And also she thought about what worked for him. She remembered, when was it a good time for him to get his hair cut? When she had the barber come to the home, put a guard on, he had his snacks, he had a TV with his favorite show, and getting his hair cut was no problem. But I think all the community, I think she was really brave, and I think she was being a big leader, and I commended her, and I thanked her for standing up for her kid, because that was really hard for a woman to stand up in a barbershop and say, no, enough, I'm going to allow my kid to cry, and I'm going to stay and listen to my kid while he cries, and I'm going to comfort him.